ready for us to start our Mass. Ding, ding.
It's Easter and it's Sunday. We'll sing as many verses of Jesus Christ as we know. Jesus Christ is risen today.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, I am a good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd, and whose sheep are not his own, sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am a good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice. And there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I see dead people all the time. They're everywhere. A few of you might remember that iconic line from a movie called The Sixth Sense, 1990, the story of a boy who people thought had a mental illness because he sees dead people who don't know they're dead. Kind of like Charles Dickens' story, The Christmas Carol, where Ebenezer Scrooge speaks to the ghost of Jacob Marley, his business partner, and the ghosts of Christmas past, present, and future. And the movie has a great twist at the end, and I'm not one of those fans of the science fiction thriller type movies. I won't spoil it for those of you who haven't seen the movie, but it's worth watching, especially when you look at it through a Christian lens. But folks, that science fiction thriller movie and Dickens' story of Christmas Carol reminds us that we're all like that, because we all see dead people all the time. Because let's face it, folks, we all know that on the human level, this ain't gonna last forever. So very really, we are all walking and talking and living dead people. It's just a matter of time, right? And the clock is ticking. And with every beat of our heart, we draw closer to that moment when this will be no more. That's the universal experience. Everybody faces death. But the difference between the people out there and the people in here, or in John's gospel, the people in the world and the people in the church, the people in the darkness, the people of the light, is different, because that Easter candle that burns symbolizes the one who once was dead and is now alive. And in his victory, he becomes the light of the world, conquering the darkness of selfishness, sin, and death. So while many out there think that death has the last word, and we're all familiar with their slogans, aren't we? Come on, we all know their slogans. The carpe diem, seize the day, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we die. We ain't here for a long time, so golly, let's have a good time. The very fatalistic understanding of what human life is all about, that it ends. And so you might as well go for the gusto, go strong or go home, right? Wrong. Because those with the faith who know that Jesus, who once was dead and is now alive, that all the good things that we experience in this world, the beauty of creation, the beauty of things that man, the artists, can whet our appetite to long for the one who gives everything to us in spades. Because death for us, my brothers and sisters, does not have the final word. Christ the Lord, risen from the grave, has the final word. And what are his words? His words are, I am the good shepherd. Fear not, for I am alive. He speaks to his words of comfort, love, and life. So therefore, my brothers and sisters, no longer, when we know, we just had a very poignant example of it, didn't we? Where we looked at Ambrose, Gervais, and Protes. That one day, that's what's going to be left of us. But just like them, we realize that that's just the bottom part of the iceberg. The rest of it has already made it into eternal glory. So a message of great consolation and great hope, because death has been conquered. And therefore, we can, ironically, eat, drink, and be merry, because it's going to get even better tomorrow. This is just designed to show us if life on earth can be this good, having lunch in the Piazza Duomo, with the cathedral behind us, if with family and friends enjoying such a wonderful day, can you just imagine what the Good Shepherd has waiting for us? I'm not sure we can even imagine it. And so, my brothers, rejoice and sing your hallelujahs heartily, because death has been conquered and life rules the day. Christ is alive, and that changes everything.